Hi everyone, it's Dallas, and before I get into this update, I just wanted to thank everyone who has posted well wishes and their thoughts and prayers for me and my mum. That is just so lovely, so I wanted to thank you all for doing that. I'm sorry I haven't replied to each of the well wishes individually, but as you can understand, it has just been a horrible 2 weeks for us. So anyway, on to the update. My mum had actually had keyhole surgery for another problem, and then the next day as she was leaving hospital, she had to be rushed back. They didn't even make it home, so rushed back, and she ended up in intensive care in the cardiac unit at the local hospital there. And a few days later she was transferred to a bigger metropolitan hospital, still in a cardiac care unit. And at that stage we had no idea what was going on. We just knew that her heart was weak, and that was sort of all we knew. We knew that they couldn't operate because she's an elderly patient, and they just didn't think that she would survive an operation. So it was absolutely terrifying for about a week, and I wasn't able to talk to my mum, of course, during those few days. And it was devastating. As an only child, it was just, to think that you would never hear her voice again was just flat out devastating. And to top it all off, this was, you know, my birthday happened during this time as well as Mother's Day. So to think that my mother would pass during this period of, you know, the year was just gut-wrenching on top of everything else. But the doctors in the Metropolitan Hospital were wonderful, and they diagnosed what her problem is. It turns out she actually did have a cardiac arrest while they were rushing her back coming home, and she didn't have to be operated on, thankfully, and now it looks like she will just be on medication for the rest of her life. I get to talk to her now. She's in the hospital rehab at the moment. She's doing physio and preparing to come home. So that is just, it's wonderful to be able to share with you, but I'm actually surprisingly getting a little bit teared up because it's the first time I've actually spoken to anybody outside my immediate family about this. So it's just, it has really brought home, I mean, I love my mum, she's a single parent and I'm an only child, so we do have a really wonderful bond. But to be confronted with the reality that one day she won't be there was just, oh, as I'm sure some of you can understand, if you have faced this, it is, I mean, you know your parents aren't always going to be there, but it's that moment of absolutely, this is reality, this could be it, that it was just, yeah, it was just, it's been a really testing couple of weeks. So that's about all I can say, is just thank you for just being there, for your well wishes, and just to let you know that my mum is improving and it looks like she could be home within the next couple of days, maybe by the weekend. So I'm so happy that this has actually resolved itself in a more positive manner than what the doctors were first letting us know about. So as you can see, I'm still all scattered and all over the place, and when I talk about this I unsurprisingly do get emotional. But yeah, it's just it was wonderful to sort of know that there are other people who don't really know me but who still are kind enough to send their well wishes that really did help me through some of this. I would go back and read the comments and it would perk me up for a while. So you know, you never know what your comments are going to mean to somebody, and I'm just letting you know that they were so appreciated, so thank you very much. And hopefully now that I know that she's going to be fine, fingers crossed, knock on wood and all that, that I will at least have a couple of more years with my mum. And yeah, hopefully now that all that the horror of the last 2 weeks is over, I should be able to hopefully pick up where I was and get back into maybe a bit of filming. So anyway, I just wanted to let you know what was going on, and I hope I will see you sooner rather than later. So thank you very much, and until I see you guys next time, happy reading.